Good morning, students. Welcome back to your maths class. Children, we'll start chapter number 7 today, that is triangle. In this chapter, we'll discuss about the congruent figures, congruency of triangle, and some other concept of triangle like isosceles triangle, equilateral triangle also. Now, first of all, what do you mean by congruence of triangle or the congruent figure? हाँ जी, first of all, just remind few things that are congruent, that are same shape and of same size. For example, two bangles of same size, two ATM cards issued by the bank, or coins of same denominations or of same years, that are congruent. Now, what about the congruence of triangle? You know that a triangle has six parts, three sides and three angles. When you have to prove that the two triangles are congruent, you have to prove at least three parts equal. But that are not of your own choice. There are some criterias by which you can prove that two triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, you have to prove three parts, then automatically rest of the three parts will be equal. Now, we'll discuss about the congruent rule of the triangle. Now, there are some criterias related to the congruence of triangle. The first one is SAS, congruence rule. The meaning of this is, if two triangles are congruent, the meaning of this, if two sides and the included angle. Now, there are two triangles given to you. Two sides are equal, here AB and PQ are equal, and BC and Q are equal, and included angle, included between these two sides, here angle B and here angle Q are equal, then the triangles are congruent. In class 7th, you have done how to write the triangles are congruent. Now, in this case, triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR. This is the sign of congruency. And AB, the corresponding part, first is AB is equals to PQ, BC is equals to QR, and angle B is equals to angle Q. So this is by the criteria SAS. Now, the second criteria we have, angle, side, angle, congruence rule. Now he says two triangles are congruent if two angles and the included side of one triangle are equal to the two angles and the included side of other triangle are equal. Means here 60 degree and 60 degree, 70 degree. In this triangle X, Y, Z, two angles are given 60 and 70, and included side, that is Y, Z. And in this one, one angle 70, one angle 60, and line is LM. So we'll write here triangle Y, Z, X. We are taking, this is our first part, angle Y, then this side YZ, and this angle Z is congruent to triangle MLN. Now just see, YZ is equals to ML, this included side, angle Y is equals to angle M, then included side YZ and ML, and then angle Z is equals to angle L. These are equal, So these two triangles are congruent by SAS congruence rule. Now our third criteria is SSS congruence rule. If three sides of one triangle are equal to the three sides of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. Now here, triangle ABC and DEF, these are given to you. AC is equals to DF, AB is equals to DE, and BC is equals to EF. The meaning of this is triangle ABC is congruent to triangle. We have written the name ABC. So the triangle will be DEF. Triangle DEF. These are congruent. After that, we have our next criteria, RHS. That is applicable on right angle triangle. In case of right angle triangle, if the hypotenuse and one of the side of the triangle are equal, then the triangles are congruent. Here, triangle ABC, AB 5 cm, and the other triangle is QRP. So our first part is angle A is equals to angle Q, right angle. Hypotenuse BC is equals to RP, and one of the side AB is equals to QR. So triangle ABC is congruent to triangle QRP by RHS. Till this you have done in class 7th. Now there is one more criteria, that is angle-angle side. Means if any two angle and one of the side of a triangle is equals to the any two angle and the corresponding side of the triangle are equal, then the triangle are congruent. Now just see, if two angles of a triangle are equal, then the automatically third angle will also be equal. So now any two angle, 50 and 60 here given to you, same way here. Then this side and this side, one of the side is equal given to you. So in this case also triangles will be congruent. Now there is one more point. In congruent triangles, corresponding parts are equal. In short form, we say is CP, CT, that you have done in class 7th also. That is corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Now if I say that triangle, suppose I am taking this example, the triangle ABC is congruent to triangle PQR by SAS congruence rule. These three parts are equal given to you. So then after that we can say AC will be equals to PR by CPCT. Clear?